Hey booze, how you doing? It is your girl Tasha, and we are back to talk episode 5 of the X Factor USA. So let's get into it. We're still auditioning, and we jump right back to Providence, Rhode Island, and from Jump Street, you guys just wanted to come out really disrespectful. All right, so we get Malibu's Most Wanted in the form of Mr. Adonis and his friend, cousin, brother, I don't know, his friend John. They call themselves OG, original Greeks. So yeah, from Jump Street, we're not seeing anything that's going to be good out of this audition. But they did try it. They auditioned with Lionel Richie's Hello, and it was pretty horrible. I mean, instead of hello, it was hell no, because that wasn't good, all right? Then we get this montage of no's from the judges, because I don't know what's going on in Providence. Maybe this was later in the day. I don't know if this was like the second or third day that they were in Providence, but it was just a slew of negative contestants coming up to audition, and it didn't work out in their favor. But finally, we did get somebody who's going to give us a little bit of potential in the form of 15-year-old Dinah Jane Henson. Yes, that's her name, and she gave out her whole family's business, telling that there was 20 people living in a 4-bedroom house there. So we're just hoping that DSS or CPS doesn't show up tomorrow. She auditions with If I Were a Boy by Beyonce, and it was nice. I liked it. She ended up getting 4 yeses. It didn't blow me out of the water, you know what I'm saying? So it wasn't like, you know, what Melanie Amaro did when she did her Beyonce song, but it was still nice, and it was very good to hear from her. So looking forward to see what she does in boot camp, you know, just gets a little bit of more work in. She's 15 years old. I guess you can, but you know, I really don't expect a 15-year-old to blow me out of the water anyway. All right, after that, Mr. Aaron Ray, and you guys may remember him from last season. He auditioned as a solo act, but he didn't make it all the way through, so he was put into a group, and that group was Intensity. Intensity did go into the finals, but they did not win. So he came back to audition again as a solo artist, because that's what he wants to do. Aaron Ray, he did an original song, and I liked it. He sounded pretty good. Again, didn't blow me out of the water, but it was a really good audition, and I believe he did end up getting 4 yeses. So that sets off a montage of yeses, and it was nothing but like young kids. So I'm thinking, because even, you know, with prior audition episodes, it's been the young kids who are really showing, I guess, the most potential or whatnot. So I think season 2 is going to go to somebody, you know, pretty young or younger than even Melanie. Melanie was what, like 18, 19, 20? I can't remember how old she was. But I think like somewhere around the age range of 13 to 16 could possibly be the season 2 winner. I don't know. But yeah, that whole montage of yeses, Tasha Love the Kids, I'm not going to complain about that. Then Rhode Island, you guys once again want to disrespect us in the form of Chang Lee. Now, she's been in America, I think, for 12 years, she said. Still having trouble speaking the native language here, which is not Ebonics, but English. And so she decides that she wants to be disrespectful and do My Heart Will Go On by Celine Dion. And honey, it wasn't good. It wasn't good at all. She's 52 something years old. I don't know. But yeah, it was funny though. And Brittany had the audacity to tell her that singing is not what she should be doing. Maybe she should try dancing. I don't know, but Brittany, you tried it with that comment, all right? All right, so we're changing things up. We are heading down south, coming back to Greensboro, and I am waiting for Terrellyn Ramsey to audition. Okay, we'll talk about Terrellyn when they actually show her, because they didn't show her this episode. But anyway, setting things off in Greensboro was Austin Corini. He's this really super cute, blonde-haired boy. He had a little mohawk thing going on. 2 girls randomly. Well, I didn't randomly. They kind of stalked him and then asked him for his autograph. The dude, I don't know. I thought maybe he had been on Nickelodeon or something, you know. Because why are you asking this dude for his autograph? He hasn't even auditioned yet, so anyway, that's what kids do, I guess. But anyway, he got out there. He was nice, you know. He sounded better than Justin Timberlake. What's the other Justin? Justin Bieber. He sounded better than him. But, you know, the girls like him. He's cute, so he's marketable. I agree with what Demi and with what Salmon said. You know, he's going to need some work, and he can get that in boot camp. So, of course, they put him through. Then they showed, like, a quick audition from this guy named Nick who did Vanilla Ice, Ice Ice Baby. And then they showed Brittany. She got up and kind of was dancing, and I was like, Brittany, what are you doing? I've seen you dance a lot better than that. So I was a little embarrassed, but anyway, I would have been jamming right next to Britney because honestly I like that song. So Nick made it through. He brought a lot of energy to the song, and even though he kind of fumbled on some of the words, hopefully there's some real deal, you know, artistry within Nick, because I was actually kind of surprised to see him go through. But anyway, that's what happened there. Then there was this couple that was, you know, all lovey-dovey on each other, and the group was called Jamie. I don't know where that came from. I missed all that. But anyway, they got up there, and it kind of reminded me of Carmen, because I don't know why they reminded me of Carmen, but they reminded me of Carmen Wannabes. They sang an original tune that they wrote, and I will honestly have to say it didn't sound bad. And maybe because it was the corny choreography and the whole corniness of them that didn't go through, and that's why they didn't get through to boot camp. I don't know. I would have liked to kind of had them at least get three yeses just so that we can hear them do a real song. Not that their song is fake, but, you know, I wanted to hear them sing something else because there's a small little smidgen of something nice within them, but oh well, they didn't make it. Maybe next year. Next up was David Corey. He's 26 years old. He came out, and I forgot what he sang. But he did. I do remember his audition, and he did good. I actually liked him, and I agree with LA on this one that he does need some work, but there is something there. So he got through, and then we jump skip all the way to the West Coast, and we hit San Francisco up. And out of San Francisco, first we get Miss Sophie Simmons. She is Jean Simmons' daughter. She did not tell her father that she was auditioning until the day before. So she brings him in. Is that his wife? I guess that's his wife. Or whoever, with them to the auditions. And, you know, she doesn't want to use his celebrity to get into the music industry. So that's why she's auditioning. But why would you bring your father to the auditions if you don't want... Okay, you see where I'm going with this? Yeah, but anyway. So Sophie gets up there. This is my first time ever hearing her sing. I've seen her, like, on his reality show and whatnot. But this is my first time hearing her sing. And I liked her. She did an Adele song. I can't remember what the name of it was. But I liked it because y'all know I love raspy singers. There's a unique tone in her voice. So I was just praying. I was praying the whole entire time. I was like, God, please let them say yes to her. LA gave her the only no out of the group. So she got three yeses. I don't understand LA why he would not send her through. Maybe I think he was just hating because, you know, she's Jean Simmons' daughter. And he was like, well, if she don't make it through X Factor, she can just go through her father and stuff. But LA said no, but Demi, Brittany, and Simon all said yes. So I'm ecstatic about that, and I'm happy about her. I'm gonna give Sophie I was gonna give her the best audition, but she's not the best audition. There's another guy that's coming up who had the best audition. But anyway, after her came this girl named Tara Simon. Tara Simon was talking a lot of smiggity smack. She said she wants to take out Christina Aguilera. She wants to take the positions of one of the judges. She even tried it. And when LA asked her, well, whose position are you gunning for? She was like, well, I don't know. You know, whose ever position is going to be open, I assume, is one of the girls. I was like, okay, you're kind of telling the truth, but you ain't really had to say it like that. But anyway, Simon was trying to have her dig a hole that she couldn't get out of. And she kind of halfway went into that hole anyway. But she started singing, and I didn't know after she started singing. I forgot what she did some rendition of Without You from, you know, David Guetta. And it was, I don't know how I feel about it because I didn't like it, but I did not like it at the same time. So the judges decided to send her through, I think. I can't remember because it was just really weird. So yeah, I don't know, Tara. We'll see. I can't remember if she made it through or not. I kind of blacked out. I was doing something else. I'm sorry. But anyway, then coming up to audition, I think he had the best audition of the whole entire night, Mr. Daryl Black. He did a song by Gym Class Heroes. He kind of changed the arrangement up a little bit and slowed it down. And amazing. Like, as soon as he started singing, I was like, yes, he doesn't need to sing anymore. Send him on through. He's an older guy. He's a father, married, and all that stuff. So, and even Simon said it. He had the best quote. He was like, that's the type of person you want to say yes to. So, definitely be looking out for Daryl Black, because he is going to give, you know, people like Paige Thomas a run for their money. And I think people were even on Twitter saying that, you know, he could possibly be the winner. So, he didn't grab me like that. You know, I'm still waiting for that Melanie Amaro grabbing, yes, this is the winner who I'm rooting for. I don't know if I'm going to get that until maybe after boot camp, it seems like. But we only have one more audition episode, which is tomorrow night. So you guys know where to tune in for another recap for that on tomorrow, all right? Go ahead and leave your comments below tonight. What did you guys think of all tonight's antics? Tomorrow, honey, we're going to get some drama because Trevor was going to audition. He's a little 13-year-old. He was going to audition on tonight, but something happened. They were calling his name and he wasn't where he's supposed to be, and they showed him lying down with his mother and stuff like this. They're gonna have to call the paramedics. Yes, you know, X Factor is trying to service up some drama, so tomorrow we're gonna get the drama. All right, you guys tune in tomorrow. Leave your comments down below. Make sure that you're following me on Twitter so that we can chit chat about the show while it's on, as well as like this video and subscribe if this is your first time watching. Thank you guys so much. Remember, I love you, God loves you, and Jesus can save. I'll see you guys tomorrow for another recap. Bye-bye.